Queen. let's stand together for our opening song, Open the Eyes of My Heart.
I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, sin in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Let his camp become desolate,
and may no one dwell in it, and may another take his office. Therefore, it is necessary that one of the men who accompanied us the whole time, the Lord Jesus, came and went among us, beginning from the baptism of John until the day on which he was taken up from us, become with us a witness to the resurrection. So they proposed Joseph, called Barsabbas, who was also known as Justice, and Matthias. Then they prayed, "You, Lord, who know the hearts of all, show which one of these two you have chosen to take the place in this apostolic ministry from which Judas turned away to go to his own place." Then they gave lots to them, and the lot fell upon Matthias, and he was counted with the 11 apostles. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Love one another as I am. his master is doing. I have called you friends because I have told you everything I heard from my Father. It was not you who chose me, but I who chose you and appointed you to go and bear fruit that will remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you. This I command you: love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. We see the 11 apostles today in the first reading of the Acts of the Apostles coming to the conclusion that they need to fill that vacancy left by Judas, who deserted Jesus. Now, they have a criteria. Who has been with us since the time of John the Baptist? And they mention two people, Joseph and Matthias. And then, after having seen both of them qualified, well, they had to make a decision. And what did they do before they made their decision? They prayed. And after that, each of them cast their own vote, and Matthias was chosen. And the reason why I highlight this is that we have the apostles faced with a decision. Is what's the first thing they did? They prayed. And in life, we too are faced with many decisions. And let's not forget that as we talk out our decisions, as we discuss our decisions with our parents or our friends, as we do that, we should never forget too that another important part of making a decision is prayer. Prayer to Jesus and prayer to our Blessed Mother. So that we want to make good decisions. We want to make good choices in life. And sometimes it's hard to make a good choice. We don't know what the right choice is. So that we do need also to pray about it. We need to pray to our Blessed Mother, and we need to pray to Jesus, who is our friend. As Jesus says in the gospel, he calls his followers his friends. And you are followers of Jesus also. So that you, each of you, are friends of Jesus. And how do people recognize you as a friend of Jesus? Well, by the way, you live out the commandment of love. And that commandment of love that Jesus gave us is as the gospel ends: I command you, love one another. And this is something that you have been doing here since you have been students at St. Catherine of Alexandria. And you have been showing that love and learning how Jesus loved us and experiencing his love in your life, so that you may be loving people, so that you may be people that love one another, so that you may be people that are supportive of one another. That we want to build each other up. We want to support each other. We want to love each other. And we want to love our classmates, our families, our brothers and sisters. So that we have the example of Jesus, who gave us love. And we have that example in our parents, who show you their love. And Jesus' love is unconditional, that he's always there for us, whether we pray to him or whether we forget to pray to him. He never stops being with us. Now, as today, at the end of Mass, we will have our May crowning. And it's a very special way of honoring our Blessed Mother. And we sang a song at the beginning, O Mary, Queen of Heaven, O okay, and Queen of the May. And Mary has a number of titles of queen. We refer to Mary as Queen of Angels. She is the utmost angel. We refer to her as Queen of Heaven because she is in heaven with her Son Jesus. We call her the Queen of the Prophets so that she also bore witness to Jesus, and Queen of the Apostles. Well, she wasn't one of the 12, but indeed she was the mother of Jesus. And we refer to her as Queen of Martyrs. Queen of Martyrs because her own heart was broken as she was there at the foot of the cross, as she watched her Son be crucified. And we have Mary also called Queen of Virgins, that she was a virgin, and that this is an example of a holy life that Mary gives us to live. And we call her Queen of All Saints, that she is indeed rewarded with her own holiness as being a saint in heaven. And we refer to her as Queen of the Most Holy Rosary. And one of the special prayers that we have as Catholics is the rosary that we pray to Jesus, that we pray to Mary. And we also honor Mary as Queen of Peace. And we know that this world is so much in need of peace these days, and that we need to pray to Mary, the Queen of Peace, so that we do honor her and we do show our love for her today as we crown her our Queen. Please stand. And gather with chosen people, we come before God with our prayers and needs. For the church, that in unison with Mary, it may proclaim the wonderful works of God and his mercy known to all nations. For he casts down the mighty from their thrones and raises up the lowly. We pray to the Lord. For all the people of the earth, that under the impulse of the Holy Spirit, they may be gathered into the one people of God under the rule of Christ the King, we pray. Lord, hear our prayer. For harmony among nations, that through the prayers of the Queen of Peace, hatred may be laid to rest, wars ended, and all the earth enjoy prosperity and peace, let us pray to the Lord. For those who endure illness, poverty, loneliness, imprisonment, or persecution, that the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Queen of Mercy, may strengthen and encourage them with a mother's care, we pray to the Lord. For all here present that recognizing the unique dignity of the Blessed Mary, we may try to imitate her humility and her spirit of service and daily love, we pray to the Lord. And for those who remember in a special day at this Mass, Kevin Walsh, Carol Moore, the students of St. Catherine of Alexandria School, and those in our religious ed program, teachers and staff members and catechists, we pray to the Lord. And for the prayer, and now let's take a moment and make a special prayer in our hearts for whatever might be a need that you have. We pray to the Lord. God of love, we bring these needs to you today, trusting that you will give us all we need to bear fruit that will remain through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Taking the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, the church spread about the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Blaise, our Bishop, and his auxiliary bishops, and all the clergy, and all your faithful people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of resurrection, and all that died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
this heart adore you. This is my daily bread.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. In our prayer to Saint Joseph, Saint Joseph, watch over me and care for me, just as you cared for the child Jesus. And by your help, may I come to know your Son, and so grow in strength and wisdom and the favor of God. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and ever living God, restore us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ. Increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this pastoral sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of your saving food. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, Father, and Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in the peace of Christ. Thanks be to God.
Now in heaven with Jesus our King. Father, trusting thy gentle care to prove. On this day, O beautiful Mother, on this day, we give thee our love. Near thee, Madonna, fondly we hover, trusting thy gentle care to prove. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today. Queen of the angels, Queen of the May. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today. Queen of the angels, Queen of the May. O Mary, we crown thee with blossoms today. Queen of the angels and Queen of the May.